Tank without infantry, moving straight into a trap. We lost a lot of tanks that way. Infantry without tanks, walking straight into a nest that could have been crushed. We lost a lot of men that way. But we learned a lesson, too. We learned that infantry needs tanks, and that tanks need infantry. We learned that when both worked together, the tank got the benefit of the infantry's ability to maneuver, and the infantry got the benefit of the tank's armored firepower. Aimed small arms fire from concealed positions aided the tank. Machine gun and cannon fire aided the infantry. Taken together, that meant greater battle efficiency. We also learned that when both worked together under a single command, the problem of control was simplified. Communication was simpler, organization was simpler. And that meant greater battle efficiency. The upshot was the development of the infantry tank team, a composite unit operating under a single command. A new technique learned in combat. And here it is. Two tanks with deployed infantry forming the team. A pair of scouts out in front of each tank, 30 to 70 yards ahead. The BAR team on one flank, usually where observation is best. Then the rifle team, placed to favor its fire and maneuver. And finally, the leader, located where he can best control his unit. Here are a few things to remember about our tanks. They can ford a stream up to a depth of 3 feet. They can climb a pretty steep grade, up to 30 degrees. Their heavy armor is in the front and on the turret. Two machine guns and a 75 millimeter gun on the turret. One bow machine gun, and sometimes a flamethrower. Small infantry tank units usually operate in build-up areas, in wooded terrain, or in the jungle. In terrain such as this, tanks can give the infantry plenty of protection. Notice there is no confusion in mounting a tank. Three men on each side. A system for handling your rifle. Ropes to help you get aboard and stay aboard. Definite positions for each man. First two in the center. Second two forward. Last two in the rear. Vantage points for complete observation in all directions. Communication. The hand signal, signaling the tank to advance and indicating its next position. Then there's the telephone. The tank takes a position that protects you, and the tank commander doesn't have to unbutton to talk to you. If other means of communication fail, here's a field expedient to use in an emergency. The tank is buttoned up. You've lost contact with the tank commander. Just turn the periscope in the direction you want the tank commander to look. Then move to that direction yourself, and you're in contact. Here's still another means of communication between infantry and tanks, an SCR 300. Often one of these is available in the platoon leader's group. Here's a typical example of how the infantry tank team operates. The objective is an enemy position, a machine gun and an anti-tank gun emplaced on this ridge. The intermediate objective is a machine gun emplacement in the woods, here. Behind the line of departure, the infantry tank team is divided into medium tank and infantry squad on the left, same on the right. Out in front, the leading squad has finished its reconnaissance and is moving out to set up a base of fire, here, to support the action. Finally, platoon headquarters, from which the platoon leader can observe the enemy position. And here it is on the ground. The tank section is well concealed behind the line of departure. The squad designated as base of fire begins to move out. They will set up the base of fire here, in a position to cover both the intermediate and the final objective. And here they come, scouts well out in front, the rest of the squad advancing in a column. Creeping at first, then crawling to the initial position. Once the base of fire is set up, the tanks move out. Then comes the infantry. On approaching the woods ahead, the tanks move into a column. This is the formation generally used in close terrain, such as villages, jungles, and other localities where visibility is limited. A tank always draws fire. To avoid casualties through ricochets, the infantry is well dispersed. VAR team on one side of the tank, rifle team on the other. Taking cover. Rolling to escape gunfire because the enemy aims where you drop. Scouts go ahead, the eyes of the tank, looking for obstacles, for mines, for swamps or ditches the tanks can't negotiate. A mine. The tank is headed straight for it, but not for long. That's how you tell the driver to shift his course. And that's one reason why tanks need infantry.